Bonsoir, bienvenue sur Arte Concert. On est tellement heureux de recevoir ce groupe anglais qui est issu de la nouvelle scène jazz londonienne. Ils sont fantastiques, c'est des tueurs. Ezra Collective, sur la scène de Ground Control.
Good,
DJ, Femi, thank you for coming. So I don't know, like, what are we going to talk about? The process?
Yeah, man.
The influences? You know, well, the basic stuff.
Exactly, musician to musician, it
exactly.
will feel natural. Do you know what I'm saying?
Chords.
Chords. I'm a drummer, so easy with the chords.
Rhythm.
Yeah, but you know, yeah. You play percussions, like classical percussion?
I play the piano.
You play the piano, yeah. Which is a percussion?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Exactly. So yeah, now looking forward to it. Thank you.
Things in there.
Yeah. Man. All
right.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
Right, yeah. You like the backstage?
I like the vibe.
Yeah.
Like the vibe. It feels like home. It feels good to be here.
Good to be here. Definitely.
So you are a collector, you told me.
I'm a big record collector. My favorite thing is to, when I'm traveling the world on tour and whatever, you know, best record store in Sao Paulo. You go there, and I'll try to buy the music from that place, and then I bring it back to London, and I've got a slice of the world in my house at all times. So yeah, I love records. It's everything, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, of course, I do the same. Exactly the same, finding the best one. I look if they have like a score section.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Okay, beautiful. Yeah, I think, I just tend to like, Wherever I am, if it, like, I'm in Argentina, I want to find some tango music, Brazil, mm-hmm. some samba music, Nigeria, some afrobeat, all of that kind of thing. Mm. I just kind of, yeah, man, it's beautiful. And it's just got so much history, so much knowledge, all of it inside the record. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
So you come from the UK?
Yeah, London. We're both Londoners. Yeah. So,
but from Nigeria. And from Nigeria.
Exactly. Yes. Nigeria via London.
Yeah.
So we were with qu’Ezra before. He's from Nigeria also.
Yeah. Yes.
Growing up in London. You know the country?
Yeah, man. It's just Lagos. I think for me personally, is my favorite place in the world.
Oh, really?
It's just the energy. The it's so loud. It's so busy. There's something going on every second, and it helps you understand why the music that comes from Nigerians, from Lagos, from West Africa is so powerful and so amazing. There's so much in that city. There's not a second where something isn't going on, do you know what I mean? And it's a really wonderful place.
And I think that's half of the reason that when we come to London and you have those people come in and the people, like, you know, from Lagos, from Nigeria come in and it's hard to get that out of you, you know what I mean? But there's so many strong cultures in London. Mm. It's a big melting pot, a big mixing pot, and then we end up with so many different, I guess, things and ideas and an open mind to different people in different places, which is like, a massive benefit of where we're from.
So obviously, Fela Kuti is the big influence.
Yeah.
I can really hear the arranging of the horns in your album.
Yeah.
Your fantastic album, really.
Oh,
I dived
you.
Into it so much, listened to it 3 times in a row.
Oh, beautiful.
And how do you write the horns?
I think the horn lines tend to come from just a single melody idea, whether it's just kind of, whether it's in unison or just a single line, whether someone sung it or played it on their horn. And then once you get it, it's just kind of like, I think we tend to just think, how do you make it sound as big as possible?
Yeah.
But it's just the five of us in the room. Do you know what I mean? So it's like, and that's for me, how I love horns.
You play bass, you play the drums.
Keys, then trumpet and sax. Yeah.
Trumpet and sax, and they sound that big.
Yeah, so there's lots of little tricks and flicks that you can do. Some overdubbing, some, you know, just this type of microphone, stand away from it, stand close to it, and you just try and make it sound big.
Of 2023, and I'm glad we get to spend it with all of you. On the keys, my brother, man like Joe Armon-Jones, make some noise. On the trumpet, Ife Ogunjobi, make some noise. On the tenor saxophone, James Mollison III, make some noise. TJ Koleoso on bass. My name is Femi Koleoso on the drums. We are the Ezra Collective, playing a mixture of jazz, afrobeat, reggae, and everything in between. You get what I'm saying, people? Enjoy yourself, dance, and make some noise. God bless you all. Bye.
I want to show the people the homage you are paying to Thelonious Monk, the great piano player, that the iconoclast piano player that plays like no other piano player. This record from Underground from Thelonious Monk. So it's a big influence to you, Thelonious Monk?
I love Thelonious Monk, and I think one of the reasons I love him so much because he's the jazz musician that can divide opinions sometimes. Yeah. I remember going to jazz school, some people be like, Thelonious Monk, greatest, exactly, doesn't know how to play, doesn't know his chords, can't play a melody properly. And then some people be like, Thelonious Monk, greatest jazz composer of all time. Yeah. And I love that because I don't care about the harmony or the theory or whatever. I just like, this music makes me dance. When I hear like Evidence, it just makes me dance, like it's so rocking. I mean, all of his records are special to me, but more than just his records, this for me is one of my favorite album covers of all time, beyond jazz music, because I can't stop looking at it. And we wanted to create something where it's like, I can't stop looking at it. Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying? And that's kind of where it came from. I think also we just kind of imagined like, why was he here? Like, what is this? And to me, it looks like a wartime bunker, which is how lockdown made us feel.
Yeah.
It made me feel like I was in a bunker. Yeah.
You did it during the lockdown?
Exactly. It feels like he's hiding away from, do you know what I mean, something outside. And that's what lockdown made us feel like. We're hiding away from something outside.
Yeah.
So yeah, man, very special tribute to him.
Yeah, for the people like Thelonious Monk wrote this. One of the most famous songs, it's called Around Midnight.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the album is really fantastic. I really love it. It made me thought of so many things that I adore. Dub, there is Latin music. Yeah. How did you do?
It's just like, we're 90s babies. I'm born in 94, he's born in 96. And I like to say we're the playlist generation of music. Mm-hmm. Once upon a time, you could only listen to one record at a time. You put it on, you listen to the whole record, and then you change the side and listen to the whole record. Whereas now, you might be on, Spotify or iTunes or Tidal or something. You press play, and then it shuffles.
Mm.
And so it's like, you might be listening to Thelonious Monk 1 second, and then straight after it plays some D'Angelo, and then straight after it's like your favorite Debussy track, and then straight after that, it's like, oh yeah, I remember, I loved Britney Spears. And it just keeps doing that all the time. And so I think the way that we tried to make this was like paying homage to shuffle culture, but also we love the album. So there was no influence that couldn't make it onto the record. Do you know what I mean?
And I think one of the amazing things about being a quintet and having five of us in the band and then not being like this one person that comes up with all the ideas, it's all of us that are coming together. We all grew up in a slightly different way. You know, I remember we grew up listening to maybe hip hop, and then I went through a phase of listening to a lot of rock and a lot of, metal music, listening to a lot of reggae. Joe loves dub music. So whenever we come together and we make this music, we don't feel like imposters. Because there really is a genuine connection to this music, and there's a respect for the music. And so when we're writing this music, even though there's five or six different subgenres on the album, every song should sound like Ezra, because it really is
it's
Ezra. That's a big thing that's helped us to kind of curate this album that's so different, but at the same time, it makes sense. ¶¶
before we carry on, I want to say a shout out to the greatest drummer that ever lived. Make some noise for Tony Allen. He called Paris his home, so it's only right we pay tribute to him. We played a track entitled No Confusion, and then Fela Kuti's Lady. This next track is off our latest album, Where I'm Meant to Be. This track is entitled Live Strong.
Thank you.
Have you studied with Tomorrow Warriors, that program?
Yes.
Can you tell us about that program?
Tomorrow's Warriors is a youth it's a youth club that centered itself around teaching kids to play jazz music. And it was beautiful. It was also free, which meant it was inclusive. You know, anyone could go, anyone could turn up.
It was cheap?
No, it was free.
It was free?
Yeah, it was free. It was free. Ooh, nice. So it was like, so it meant we could go, we could turn up, we can be a part of it. And they taught me not just, they taught me Autumn Leaves and Olio. They taught me Sonny Rollins music. And the first time I ever played a tune like Caravan would have been there or something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But at the same time, they taught us how to love and appreciate this music, but how to innovate it and take it to a different place. So it really was the nuts and bolts of what ended up becoming so much of the jazz music coming out of London was a big part of what their influence on all of our music. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man. It
so
was
you
very
met
special.
the other bands of the Ezra Collective there?
Yeah, that's where we all.
So many of
the
us,
five
yeah.
of you.
Yeah, man, that's where we all linked up. Apart from the two of us.
Yeah, so we're brothers.
You knew.
Yeah.
We know each other for a little bit.
I was forced to know him, but the rest of them I met normally. Yeah.
But it was the culture in that place. You know, there was a culture that Gary Crosby especially really enforced in that place, which was, it was an open-mindedness. They always used to say, each one teach one. There was a, for me, who I wasn't good at bass.
Really?
You know, at all. Yeah, I played in church with the church music there. I knew the church music, and so I played the church music. Then I turned up and I heard, a few players. When I first came to the jam session, it was the scariest day
so
of my
scary,
life.
Man, so scary, man, so intimidating.
Scariest day of my life. He said, everyone's playing the blues, and there was this kid that we all know, Charlie Stacey, he's a keys player. And he was playing over this thing. And I remember walking in and I felt lightheaded because of how quick this, and I thought, I can't be here. And Gary came over and I was just playing like one, I was just holding the one. And he literally came to me and was just like, your timing, just keep playing that note. And for some reason, he made me feel like I could play jazz. He made me feel like, and that was the superpower of Tomorrow's Warriors. It took people like me and us and put us in the same room as these people that we otherwise would have thought, oh, I could never be like that. Mm. And it just gave us the confidence to just keep going, just keep pushing, just keep pushing. And that's how I guess the culture still remains today,
where
we try and be as open with the music that we're writing and things like that.
You chose the bass because your grand brother was playing drums
you wanted to
bounce.
I wish it was, Femi was been playing drums since, how old?
Four years old, something like that.
I kind of just, I liked a load of different things. I didn't pick an instrument. I kind of just all different things. And then the bass guitar player at our church moved on to another church. And my dad said to me, we need a bass player. You've got 2 weeks. And that was it. The rest is history. So,
How old are you?
I'm 28. I had to think there.
28?
Yeah. Yes, 28.
And I'm 26.
So, okay. Yeah. So you see, the classical, people train classically, know, all jazz. This rigorous work, sometimes doesn't allow you to dive into other music.
But what
I like about today, nowadays, is that those people, serious people that working classically and jazz, they can open their ear.
Yeah, but I think for me, if you're studying jazz music and you're only listening to jazz music, I would say you're probably studying it badly. Because if you look at the greats from Miles Davis, Dizzy Gillespie was listening to Afro-Cuban music. That's why it had that effect on him. Yeah. Charles Mingus talks all about the classical music he was listening to. Yeah. So much of this music comes from finding other things and finding other influences.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm excited by the sound of people listening to what they... I didn't even know you had that. Exactly.
Yeah.
You already.
He's the greatest.
He wrote his autobiography called Beneath the Underdog.
I read that book. It's a crazy book, isn't it?
Yeah.
That creates the best sound when it's you fuse one influence and another influence, and that's when you start to have new music.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean? And I think because often the word jazz can be intimidating because it's like, we call it jazz music and then you think like, oh, but I'm never going to be as good as Art Blakey. I'm never going to be as good as John Coltrane.
Yeah.
But I just think to myself, there's only one advantage that I have over Art Blakey, and it's I'm me, and I'm here, and I'm now. Do you know what I mean? And it's exactly. Art Blakey never heard Jay Dilla play, but I did.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like, that's the only strength and power. And so the next person, there's going to be music they've heard that I haven't heard, and that's your power. Do you know what I'm saying?
That's nice.
So yeah, man.
Yeah.
But I'm still very much intimidated by Chick Corea.
I mean, yeah.
Every now and again, there's someone.
Rest in peace.
For me, it's Jacob Pastorius. I listen to him. I'm saying, hey, it's intimidating, but
you have to invent something as deep as
Exactly.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, bro. We'll be right back.
Yeah. I mean, the other band that I get the privilege of playing with is Gorillaz. So I get to travel with Damon a lot, and then, you know, been traveling and playing. But then also the Ezra Collective been traveling and playing everywhere, traveling a lot this year. So, and I just think it adds so much to the music we make when you can see a different way of living, see a different culture, hear different music.
And there's definitely some countries you go to where you think, I don't know the next time that I'm going to be here. And I think we've just, as we've gotten older, we've made the effort a lot more to try and immerse ourselves in culture as quickly as possible.
Yeah.
So you would often try and find someone from that country and say, can you take me to, you're really good at this. He'll say, take me to, you know, where
to
people are, guy. To where the people
exactly,
are. To where
yeah.
The,
yeah. yeah, exactly.
So, yeah. So we're getting better. Yeah. We're getting better.
Yeah. I have the feeling that you're a very good social animal.
Wow, yeah.
I think you're like, because I know also that you know Steve McQueen.
Yes. Very, very special person to me.
I think
you know what it is? I love people. I love meeting people. And you've got so much to learn from everyone you meet. And it's like someone might be operating a camera. I don't know how to do that. They can teach me how to do that. Someone else might be able to direct the camera. And then it's like, okay, Steve McQueen, teach me, help me, etc.
Yeah, everybody would love to.
But how? Just, you know, right place, right time.
He called you?
The first time we met, he...
Steve McQueen, the director.
Yes.
Not Steve McQueen.
Not that one. Oh. Yeah, exactly. No, he's a fan of Ezra Collective.
Oh, yeah.
So he reached out. And he was like, you know, loves the music, loved the band, and he wanted us to play at one of the parties he was throwing.
Oh, yeah.
But before we played at the party, he called us up and was like, let's hang out. And we had breakfast together.
Yeah.
And that was where we spoke about life, we spoke about films, spoke about music, yeah. spoke Lucky. About politics. We just chopped it up. And then it was like one of those connections where it was like friends forever.
Nice.
And, you know, he's around my parents' age, so it's good to even just have someone like that, like a mentor figure that I can, even when we were putting this album together,
yeah.
I was on the phone to him all the way through lockdown. What's your advice on this? What do you think of this? And that's one of the skits on the album ends up being one of those phone calls.
Yeah.
Ah, yes. Words from Steve.
Words from Steve.
Okay, yeah. I skipped that one because I had to, but yeah. I will re-listen
yeah,
to
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
It's really good.
Thank you so much. You're going to do the sound check now?
We're going to sound check. Playing in Paris is always special. Playing in France is always special. So I'm looking forward to it today. Yeah. You know what
Welcome.
I mean?
Big up, man.
Love you so much, man.
Appreciate it.
Let's
go sound check. Let's do that.
To the sound check.
Thank you, man.
I enjoyed that.
Thank you.
That was good.
All right.
I guess you're never tired, babe.
No, man, just always at it, you know what I mean?
After COVID,
yeah, exactly.
We all realize what a break looked like and we don't want to take another one.
Are you called Femi for, you know, homage?
No, it's just my dad's best friend.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yo, Joe Armon-Jones in keys. TJ Koleoso on bass. Ife Ogunjobi on the trumpet. James Mollison on the tenor saxophone. My name is Femi Koleoso on the drums. We are the Ezra Collective. Yo, thank you for the support, man. I love coming to this place, you hear what I'm saying? But God bless you all, Ezra Collective.
De sucre et de feu. So much sugar and fire at the same time. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Merci d'avoir été parmi nous sur Arte Concert. C'était le Grand Contrôle de Ezra Collective. Bravo, merci.